Prostate cancer is really common and affects many men in the UK and worldwide. For prostate cancer, for radical treatment, the mainstays of treatment are surgery or radiotherapy. And for surgery, robotic surgery has come along in the last 10 years or so and absolutely revolutionised how well we can do the operation to be really perfect and to really minimise the invasiveness of the procedure. Traditionally for prostate cancer and the removal of the prostate for prostate cancer is traditionally done through quite a large incision in the abdomen called a laparotomy. And that has really changed since the advent of keyhole surgery and then particularly with the advent of and the invention of robotic surgery. And the idea being that you've got these small incisions, you've got these small instruments that go inside the abdomen, but the working elements within those are very, very small, much, much smaller than we would use if we were using traditional surgical methods. And it augments the skills and the talents that an experienced surgeon would have. It's got greater range of movement than my own wrist. It's got better vision than myself. It can zoom in, it can scale my movements. So it allows me to be incredibly precise, much more precise than I can do in my natural hand, but obviously as precise I would really like to be to maximize the benefits of getting the cancer out and really minimize any of the collateral damage and to avoid all those important nerves and continent structures and the things that surround the prostate that we want to keep, but we want to get the cancer out. So the pros and cons of having robotic surgery, I mean, as we just talked about, there's a huge advantage of having robotic surgery versus open surgery, but the pros and cons of really nail it down is how can we get a man's body back to how it was pretty much before the operation and minimize any longer term side effects from that. And we really concentrate on continence outcomes and we really concentrate on erection and potency outcomes. So nowadays, you know, from a complication point of view, I don't really worry about that anymore. We've done so many of these robotic operations that the risks associated with having robotic surgery now are really minimal. And the cancer outcomes are well established, but it's now just really focusing down on how can we maximize people's recovery quickly after this type of surgery? How quickly can you get back to work? What are the risks of me having continence long-term? What are the risks of me having impotence long-term? And actually, the way that we're doing it nowadays, those risks are as low as they have ever been. And I'm sure that, you know, in a few months' time or in a few years' time, they'll be better still. If you've got prostate cancer and you opt to have your prostate removed robotically, then that operation takes a few hours. It's done under a general anaesthetic, i.e. you're fast asleep. And it's the kind of operation that I may do three a day, quite commonly. So you come in often in the morning or at lunchtime, and you would expect to go home the following day, following surgery, moving about freely. You'll have a catheter in to protect your bladder and the joint from where the prostate's being removed, and that's removed after a few days or a week or so. Surgical removal of the prostate is quite a major operation, and done in inexperienced hands, there's a lot of complications that can arise. That said, with the advent of centralisation of prostate cancer operations across the NHS and in part through private practice as well, in experienced hands, with someone that's doing a lot and a high volume surgeon, high volume robotic surgeon, the risks of major complications are really minimized, are very, very low nowadays. The focus has really changed now for surgeons like myself and some of my other colleagues that do a lot of robotic surgery, is actually now the shift is to focus on what are the longer term outcomes from this? How can we really maximize? How can we really improve things? What are the small marginal gains that we can improve, not only in continence recovery and fast continence recovery, but also erectile recovery, and how can we optimize that? So the real beauty of robotic surgery is how quickly patients recover from it. Most of my patients that have their prostate removed robotically would be fine to go home the next day. And when you go home, you're walking around, you know, taking it easy, but once the catheter is removed, you really start accelerating your recovery over the first few weeks. And I've operated on professional sportsmen that are back playing professional golf or high level sports within a few weeks, and I've operated on patients in the public eye that are back in the public eye within a few weeks. Ideally though, I tend to advise my patients to have 6 weeks off work, take some space. You know, it's a big operation, you want to optimize your recovery. There's lots of rehabilitation that can be really helpful in really speeding up your recovery and maximizing how well you do in the longer term. So I tend to say, if you can take 6 weeks off work, then that's great. And also, if you feel great and you want to go back to work 3-4 weeks, you can go back as a hero rather than feeling bad that you want an extra week or couple of weeks. But robotics is, the idea of robotics is to speed up the recovery, and we do everything we can to maximize that.